what a privilege I have to be able, through internet, through Facebook, through Twitter, through whatever way, social media, we're coming to you today with this Pastor's Chat, YouTube. Hey, we really, really enjoy having a time to maybe encourage you to trust God. Our theme for these days are Psalm 910. And they that know His name, they that know His name will put their trust in Him. How well do you know God? Do you know Him enough to put your trust in Him? I have people all the time say, I have a hard time trusting God. I have a hard time putting my faith in Him. He doesn't seem to be there. Well, I can tell you, when you really meet God by this name, Elohim, there is something that takes place. You cannot be a pessimistic, negative person when you get to know Elohim. And as we've already said, that's how He introduces Himself. The very first chapter in the Bible, some 32 times, He's Elohim, God. You find over 2,300 times through the Bible in the Old Testament, He's Elohim, God. God wants you to be a person who can trust Him. He is Creator God. Now, the name is in the plural. Now, that's interesting. One God, but His name, God, Elohim, is a plural name. One God. Now, the heathen could not even have a concept of one God. You know, the heathen religions, they had a god of a sun god, they had a goddess of love, they had a god of rain, they had the god of wind, they had the god of the food. I mean, they had a different god. Matter of fact, in India, they tell me, they have, as high, I've been told, 300 million gods, 300 million. And someone said, oh no, it's only 30 million. Well, that's still quite a bit. Our God of the Bible is one God. He calls Himself one God. And so it's a plural name, but singular in essence, in one God revealing Himself in a personality of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, the Trinity. Now, you say, how do you get that? I said, the Bible teaches it, so I simply believe it. And I'm asking you to trust God by faith. You can't really explain that, but I can tell you, He is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. It embraces the Trinity. Now, what we found first is God is all that I need. He is all that I need. Now, secondly today, for a few moments, God has all that I need. He has all that I need. I'd like to read from Hebrews chapter 1. It talks about in verse 1, long ago, at many times, in many ways, God spoke to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, He's spoken to us by His Son, whom He has appointed heir of all things, through whom also He created the world. He is, Jesus, is the radiance of the glory of God and the express image and imprint of His nature, and He upholds the universe by the word of His power. He is Creator God. Now, how can we believe that God not only is all that I need, He has all that I need, and that's what this name embodies. Everything is God's by the very nature and virtue of His creation. He made it, everything. He spoke the world in existence. That's what we read here in Genesis chapter 1. Everything that exists in this world is something that He created. The Bible speaks about in Hebrews 11 that He created everything out of nothing. Out of nothing. That's impossible with the basic laws of nature as far as a human being concerned. But our God created everything out of nothing. Everything is His by virtue of His control. By His control. By Him all things consist and stay together. And then everything exists because it's sustained by Him. And then everything is His by nature of the fact He brings it to an end in the end. He is Alpha and Omega. He brings it to an end. I mean, this world is His. In other words, I can believe if it's all His, He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills, the wealth in every mine. I know His name, Elohim, and He is Creator God. I can trust Him to meet my needs, whatever they are in my life. And I pray today, If you've never put your trust in His Son, Jesus Christ, because He's the one that introduces you to the Father, that right now you would do that. And what a difference that would make. Just say, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I need a Savior. Come into my heart. Save me today. Oh, my friend, what a difference that would make. God bless. Thanks for taking a few minutes with us again today. Share this with someone else. Encourage them. God bless.